وأفوض أمري إلى الله إن الله بصير بالعباد. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ولن ترضى عنك اليهود ولا النصارى حتى تتبع ملتهم. صدق الله صدق الله العظيم. My dear brethren, in the introduction I sensed some words about a debate that had taken place between myself and a Palestinian Christian who labels himself as the liberated Christian. His people, 3 million, are in bondage, suffering from the atrocities of the Jews, but this Christian Palestinian, he says he is liberated, he is free. And I had occasion to debate with him, and in the first debate that took place in the Royal Albert Hall, he scored a point against me at the very outset. And I must tell you what that point was. You see, he said, as an Arab, he said, when we go to meet a friend, we do not go empty-handed. Would you like to translate that? He said, for my friend Ahmad Didat, he brings me a parcel well wrapped up, and when I go home and I open it, I find this book, which is entitled The Holy Bible. I couldn't bring Qurans for each and every one of you. I have brought little pamphlets. I don't know whether they have reached you, but I want to make a gesture. You see, I read to you an ayah from the Holy Quran, from Surah Al-Baqarah. That is chapter number 2, ayah number 120. News: a brother from South Africa, a non-Muslim, is here in our midst, and he wants to embrace Islam. Now, I said, not now. Time is too valuable. We don't want to waste everybody's time while the process of making them read the Shahada and explaining all goes on. I said, let's get into the meeting. Afterwards, we can do the job. But now, let me say that if we wanted to tell him about this Surah Baqarah and ayah number 120, how would he be able to find that reference in the Quran? If anybody can give me an easy way to explain to our new brother in faith how to find Baqarah, how to find Yasin, how to find Surah Talaq, how to find any reference in the Quran, how do you go about, what would you say? If the first person who gives the right answer, this Quran, this deluxe edition, is his. Anybody? Yes, my brother. Hey? Right. This Quran is yours. I find references in the Quran, most especially for the non-Arab. I do not know how easy it is for Arabs to find references in the Quran. I don't know. But for the non-Arab, very, very difficult. In an encyclopedia like the Quran, some say Surah Tawbah. Where will he find, out of 114 surahs, Tawbah? Yasin, where will he find Yasin? Surah Talaq, where will he find Talaq? So at the back of this Quran, at the right at the end, there is a very comprehensive index, just like a dictionary. What you want to know? Baqarah under B, Baqarah, it tells you chapter 2. Tawbah, where will you find Tawbah? Under T, look for Tawbah, and you'll find this chapter 9, and so on and so on. Makes things easy for you. This Quran is available, I understand, in the foyer outside, and you have a deluxe edition, and one without the gold, they're available there, as well as the literature booklets that I have written are available in the foyer. In the ayah I read to you, Allah Bari Ta'ala gives us an eternal reminder about the eternal relationship between us Muslims and the Jews and the Christians. He says, وَلَنْ تَرْضَى أَنْكَ الْيَهُودُ وَلَنْ نَصَارَى hatta tattabi'a millatahum. That the Jews and the Christians, O Muslim, remember this, that the Jews and the Christians will never, never be satisfied with you. Lan, lan. Never, never, most certainly not be satisfied with you unless you become a Jew or unless you become a Christian. Never mind how much we bend backwards, accepting all the Jewish prophets as our prophets. Without hesitation, we say that Hazrat Musa alayhi salam was a Rasulullah, messenger of God. Hazrat Dawood alayhi salam was a prophet of God. Hazrat Sulaiman alayhi salam was a prophet of God. Hazrat Isa alayhi salam was a prophet of God. We accept all the Jewish prophets as our prophets and all their heroes as our heroes. We are not talking about the modern ones. I'm talking about the biblical characters. We accept them all. Does that satisfy the Jews? Does it satisfy them? No. To the Christians we say that we believe in Jesus Christ. We believe that Jesus was one of the mightiest messengers of God. We believe in his miraculous birth. We believe in his many miracles, including those of giving life to the dead by God's permission and of healing those born blind and the lepers by God's permission. We believe that Allah saved him from that ignoble death on the cross and he is coming back. He is alive and he is coming back. Does that satisfy the Christians? Does it? No. So this is an eternal reminder. Either if we want peace, either we opt out of Islam, become Christians, or become Jews, or bring them into the house of Islam. The ayah, during the course of the introduction, another ayah was read by our chairman. Reading, قُلْ say, يَا أَحْلَ الْكِتَابِ تَعَالَوْا come. إِلَىٰ كَلِمَةٍ سَوَائِمْ بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَكُمْ that we come to common terms as between us and you. Let us get onto a common platform. For 1400 years, we are reading this ayah, تَعَالَوْا, تَعَالَوْا, تَعَالَوْا. يَا أَحْلَ الْكِتَابِ تَعَالَوْا. We are reading it in our homes, we read them in our masjids, but we have not invited the Jews and the Christians towards Islam. As a people, as a deliverer of this last and final revelation of God, this message, we have not asked the Jews and the Christians to come, that come, let us sit down and let us talk. We have stopped delivering this message. Our job. So now the Christian is doing the job. You don't invite him, he is now inviting you. And he is offering you his holy book, the Bible, in 2,000 different languages. 2,000 different languages of the world, this Bible is now obtainable. And he's offering it to you, a pamphlet they give out to Muslims. It says here, a Christian gift, bakshish, gift, bakshish, free to all Muslims, not to Hindus, not to Jews, not to other Christians, but to Muslims, especially for Muslims. The Holy Bible, the Word of God. You beggars, it's treating us like beggars, you beggars, just fill the coupon and get it. Arab brothers alone, they have 11 different Arabic Bibles, different Arabic Bibles, 11. What do you want 11 different Arabic Bibles for? I understood that there is only one Arabic language, the language of the Quran. But now the Christians know better than me, and I don't know whether you know, that there are 11 different Arabic dialects. The Arabs, they don't write the same script. They have different scripts and different lahja, dialects. 11 different Bibles from a book printed by the Christians called The Gospel in Many Tongues. In it, it says here, Arabic, the type of Arabic script that the Egyptians, Arabs, and the Saudi Arabs, they read. And maybe also it applies to the Qataris. Then there is a Tunisian script. The Tunisians, they have a different type of script. Arabic, but it's a different hand. Then they have Arabic Karshuni for the Syrians. They have Algerian colloquial. They have Algerian-Tunisian mixture colloquial. They have Egyptian colloquial, street language of Egypt, in that language also, for the ordinary fellaheen. They have Arabic Moorish colloquial, they have the Palestinian, then they have Southern Sudan colloquial, and they have the Tunisian colloquial. 11 different Bibles for the Arabs alone. They have a special love for the Arabs. They love you specially. Here is a Christian publication called Pray. Pray. That's the title of the magazine called Pray. You see, when the Christian says pray, it doesn't mean pray, it means lift up your hands and make dua. When they say pray, it means give money. That's the real prayer, give. Muslims, when you meet Muslims, you are in need of some help to do dawah. He said, make dua. So he quickly lifts up his hand, say, may Allah give you 100 years life, and you know, all the blessings, everything, because it cost him nothing. He's giving. One bank manager, I won't tell you which country, Muslim, bank manager. He was so happy with the work that we are doing. He says, you know, Mr. Didat, I want to give you the balance of my life. For example, if there's still 5-year balance for him before he can die, he's prepared to give me that 5 years and prepared to die straight away. So Didat lives for 5 years more. But he didn't give me one feel, not one halala. That is how good, you know, the Muslim is for prayer. He's prepared to give his life, but he's not prepared to put his hands in his pocket. But when the Christian says pray, it means give, and they give. You see here the picture of a Chinese or a Korean. His name given here is John Lee. He speaks about the kingdom of oil, meaning the oil-rich countries, the kingdom of oil. And among so many other things, he says, I am in Saudi Arabia, just left Kuwait. He was in Kuwait, now he's in Saudi Arabia. What this enemy of God, what was he doing in Kuwait? What was he doing in Saudi Arabia? And it's a question we want to know. How did he get into Kuwait? How does he get into Saudi Arabia? Very easy, very easy. I don't have to explain to you. But very easy for these mubashirs, these missionaries of Christianity. But now the Muslim, the Arab, he is very sensitive. In the age of the supermarkets and the hypermarkets, his feelings are also hypersensitive, the Arab. As soon as you say Kuwait, the Kuwaiti gets shaken up. So now he's attacking me now. And if I say Kuwait, the Kuwaiti says he's attacking me. If I say Saudi Arabia, the Saudi says he's attacking me now. I said, look, I'm only reading to you what this enemy of God, he is telling us that he has just left Kuwait and now he's in Saudi Arabia. This enemy of God, he says, I could think of no better or no more important time to give a lot of our attention to the Muslim world than now. Now is the time to pay a lot of attention to the Muslim world. This is the time now. Preparation is underway in Pakistan. For the last 2 years, we have been in contact with 6 key leaders in the Arab Muslim world to come up with a realistic and workable plan for every home crusade, door to door. Every home crusade. This year, we plan to open a research center in Beirut, Lebanon, to start the preparation for the entire Arab Muslim world. And it goes on and on, Arab Muslim world, and again, Muslim world, and again, Arab Muslim world. It's the Arab Muslim world that they're most interested in, the kingdom of oil. Here is the cover of a book. Cover of a book. The title is Sound the Alarm from Saudi Arabia. Written by Tom Griffith. This Tom Griffith was in Jeddah. He was in Taif. He was working among the Saudis for 10 years. He was studying the people while doing his job, whatever job he was doing. He was studying the Muslims. And now he has written a book, How to Work Among the Saudis, How to Pervert the Saudis. If you can't go door to door and knock at the doors, because the Saudis won't allow that. Maybe the Qataris won't allow that. Maybe the Kuwaitis won't allow that. Then how else can you work? There is a system. There is a way that they can get in without having to come and knock at your doors. If you will not allow them to knock at your door, these missionaries?
The postal department is there.
Here is a letter, is a photostat of a letter. This envelope is addressed from Wolverhampton in England, addressed to the manager, Sand Supermarket, P.O. Box 7807, Sharafia, Jeddah, Saudi Arabia. Inside is a coupon offering you a free Injil in Arabic. Free Injil. Won't you like to have it? You beggars, that's how they're treating you. You beggars, won't you like to have a free Injil? And out of curiosity, man can fill in the coupon. Said, let's have a look. You're getting something for nothing. I haven't seen an Injil yet. Let's have it. And getting into your homes here in Saudi Arabia, maybe in Kuwait, and maybe in Qatar. But this is the system that they're using. And Monte Carlo Radio. They're broadcasting. Day and night, they're broadcasting in Arabic. Reading the New Testament. Their New Testament. In the Tilawat al-Quran, like Abdul Samad Abdul Basit, Sheikh Abdul Samad Abdul Basit, tantalizing the people. These are new methods they have evolved to get their message to you. They do not number 2 million in the world today. They are sects and sects, denominations of Christianity. Among them, there is a group called Jehovah's Witnesses. They do not number 2 million in the world today. That little group published, among so many other things, only one book I'm referring to, 84 million copies of one book in 95 languages. 84 million. You hearing all right? I'm not exaggerating. This is from the magazine. 84 million copies in 95 languages. What language you like to read? Ahi, Arabic, they got it for you. Zulu, they got it for you. Urdu, they got it. What language in 95 different languages? And that book is not a booklet, it's not a little piece. This is 192 pages, 84 million copies in 95 languages. Little group of people. They have a magazine called The Watchtower. Buruj, The Watchtower. This is just a cover. You open inside and they tell you that the average printing of this magazine, 13,045,000 a month. In 104 languages. 13,045,000 a month in 104 different languages. We Muslims, the whole Muslim world put together, with all our petrodollars, we can't produce a million sheets like this. With all our petrodollars, you can't produce a million sheets like this for Dawah. They are doing 13,045,000 a month in 104 different languages. The same little group of people. Another magazine, they call it Awake. Wake up! They will wake up the world. Awake! They produce this magazine. $10,610,000 a month in 53 languages. 10 million a month in 53 languages. We can't produce a million sheets like this. All our petrodollars put together in a year, a million sheets we can't produce.
Nafsik Jamal.
Family, called Armstrong in America, Armstrong Family. They publish a magazine, Four Color Job, The Plain Truth. 7.8 million a month, absolutely free of charge, 7.8 million. All this is like fairy tales. Wallah, it sounds like a fairy tale. You want to have a closer look? I don't know when you can come along, have a closer look. 7.8 million a month, absolutely free, and you can't pay for your own. Free! Edward Said, a Palestinian Christian, residing in America. He's quite sympathetic to the Palestinian cause. This man, generally the Christian Arab, he's happy when the Jews knock hells into us. The Christians all over the world, they are very happy because at the back of the mind, Palestine was given by God to the Jews. From the Nile to the Euphrates, this enemy of God I've showed you, this Palestinian liberated Christian, he says, I can't understand my Arab brothers. You have million square miles of land and you are grudging your Jewish cousins a few small pieces. What is wrong with you people? God Almighty actually gave the Jews from the Nile to the Euphrates, and you mind that little piece that they want to occupy. What's wrong with you? Your cousins, your Arab, your cousins. This Professor Edward Said, he says, in the Time magazine, he says, early Christian polemicists, people who argue against Islam, want to debate against Islam, use the Prophet's human person as their butt, something to hit at, accusing him of whoring, sedition, charlatanry. As writing about Islam and the Orient burgeoned, 60,000 books have been written against Islam between 1800 and 1950. 60,000 books have been written by the Christians against Islam since from 1800 to 1950. Newsweek magazine from America, we are told here, today, more than 60% of the world's 70,000 missionaries, crusaders of Christianity, not priests, ministers of the church, paid servants of the church, no, these are the mujahids of Christianity. Out of the world's 70,000 missionaries, 60% are Americans. That is, worked out, 42,000 American missionaries are raising the dust throughout the world. Newsweek magazine from America, we are told here, today, more than 60% of the world's 70,000 missionaries, crusaders of Christianity, not priests, ministers of the church, paid servants of the church, no, these are the mujahids of Christianity. Out of the world's 70,000 missionaries, 60% are Americans. That is, worked out, 42,000 American missionaries are raising the dust throughout the world. The methods that they use. Charming, beautiful methods to catch the unwary Muslim, the Muslim fish. You see, they have been studying us. They are master psychologists. They are in the field. They study people, the customers. How to sell? How to sell? How to catch the fish? They study it. They look at the Muslims. That if a Muslim comes across anything written in Arabic, anything, in India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Indonesia, Africa, anywhere, the Muslim child picks it up, kisses it, and puts it in the Quran. We are trained because the only thing we saw in Arabic is Allah's kalam. So anything Arabic must be Allah's kalam. We don't recognize the writing, what is there. This, what I'm picking up, my child is picking up, maybe Lady Chatterley's Lover. You know, it's a book written, a filthy, dirty book in England. It was banned in my country for 20 years. It could be Lady Chatterley's Lover in English. I'm sorry, in Arabic. You tear the pages and you throw it anywhere among Muslims in the world, the Muslim child and the grown-up will pick it up, will kiss it, and put it in his pocket. So they find that this fish, the Muslim fish, they know what bait it will take. So they give you what you want. Here, look at this. Al-Kitab. Al-Kitab. Beautiful production. And Islamic calligraphy. You can't mistake it. This is Islamic calligraphy. Yes. You know what it is? It is Christianity. In the guise of this, you give it to the Muslim. Ay, mashallah. He's got something. He's going to take it home. He's going to take it home and give it to a student. My child said, look, we got something beautiful, nothing. Catching Muslim fish. Oh. You know, I got caught. They caught me. I was in Pakistan, in Karachi, delivering a lecture. At the end of the lecture, people get enthusiastic. They want to pump your hand, you know. They want to shake your hand to show you how happy they are. They don't know that so many handshakes, you can kill me, you know. But now, it's your love. You want to show your love. They just want to touch me, you know, thinking some magic. You just touch me and you get blessed. However, while this thing is going on, a young boy, probably not more than 13, he comes to me and he hands me this. You all can't see it. Beautiful, beautiful. Stickers, shining stickers. And I glanced, it look to me, and I'm showing anybody, say, what is this? And people say, Allah Muhammad. Have a look. Say, Allah Muhammad. So I saw, and I wanted to kiss it. But the people won't give me a chance. So I put it in my pocket and carried on shaking hands. From there, I go to Dubai. In my hotel, sitting on the bed, I said, let me clear my pocket. So I take it out, and I'm reading. Allah Muhammad, and something is a bit difficult, beautiful calligraphies. Abbana, in gold and black, Abbana, beautiful Islamic calligraphy. I'm thinking, Rabbana, this is the human mind. You get a little start, a cue, and you think, you imagine what is there, but it's not there. You're reading from your head. I say, Abbana, I say, Rabbana, Atina, Fid Dunya Hasanatam, Wa Fil Akhirati Hasanatam, Wa Kina Azabana. I go through the whole lot and I turn. I see at the back there, he says, the Lord's Prayer. I said, we don't talk like that. Lord's Prayer? What is this? This is the Christians talk like that. The Muslims do this. I told some Muslims, you know, I said, the Pakistanis, they did it. They beat me. I do produce some good literature. Wallah, good literature. But I said, the Pakistani beat me hands down. I didn't grudge them. Because in good works, Allah says, وَلِكُلُّمْ وِجْهَةٌ هُوَ مُوَلِّهَا فَاسْتَبِكُ الْخَيْرَاتِ. Compete with one another in good works. I said, well, the Pakistanis have beaten me. No, my brothers. But this is not Muslim. The Lord's Prayer, now I can see. He says, O our Father which art in heaven, in Arabic, Abbana. O our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done. Catching Muslim fish with this. With that, I caught an Arab sheikh in Saudi Arabia. An elderly man like myself, mature person. And I'm showing him this. So he says, I say, you look at the sheikh? He says, yes, Allah Muhammad. I say, ya sheikh, have another good look. He says, Allah Muhammad. I say, ya sheikh, have a good look. Then he says, Allah Muhabba. You can catch Arab sheikhs? What to think of the Bangladeshi and the Pakistani and the African Muslims and the Malaysians? This is how they catch Muslim fish. I said, a fair discussion is Islam encourages us. Ta'ala, come, talk to us. Ya ahl al-kitab, ta'ala. Ilaq, let's come to a common platform. But now, this is deception of the highest order. Deceiving little children, deceiving the illiterate people to kiss the snakes in the grass and take them home. Now that is something I can't stomach. Something I can't tolerate. Don't deceive people. Talk straight. He said, look, come here. I want to tell you that you Muslims are going to go to hell. You have no salvation. Salvation only comes with the blood of the Lord Jesus. All your fasting and prayer won't help you. Talk like that. I don't mind. It's a fair fight we can have. Fair discussion we can have. But don't deceive people. In Egypt, one of our biggest Arab brothers. There was a time when Umm Kulsum was alive. She's dead now. Umm Kulsum. You heard the name Umm Kulsum?
Sure.
She used to sing on Cairo radio. Allah Muhabba, Allah Muhabba. And the whole of Egypt say, Allah Muhabba, Allah Muhabba. Look, Allah Bari Ta'ala gives us in the Quran 99 attributes. His shifa, his qualities. But Muhabba is not one of them. But he's making every Egyptian, Muslim and Christian, to sing. Because the woman sings so beautifully and everybody echoes, Allah Muhabba, Allah Muhabba. They did the job. They did it to us. Now that was too small pieces. They want to help you, old people like me. See this? Beautiful. Look at this. Very, very difficult for the bulk of the Muslims of the world to recognize what they're seeing. This thing, the only thing we saw like this was the Quran. The Quran. You think this is the Quran? You think this is the Quran? You think this is the Quran? This is the Quran. All this is Christianity. All this is Christian. I was telling my Saudi brethren, I said, look, if the Saudi government gives me permission, wallah, I can get 1 million of these absolutely free of charge. And I can sell them to the Hajis at a riyal each. I can make 1 million riyal just like that. and people will buy. I just show them, I say, real each. They say, give me 5. Since they give me 10, they say, give me 100. I'll take them back and give to my people at home. I can make a million real. The Christians will give me 1,000,000. I said, 5 million. If I tell them, I said, look, I can give it to the Hajis. I must get only permission from the Saudi government. They said, look, do that, you can get them into Saudi Arabia. They won't charge me when they find out that this is Christianity. Then I said, look, I can make 1,000,000 rial. I can make 5 million rials. Just like that. Catching every Haji. Every Haji comes for Hajj, whether he's an Egyptian or a Qatari or anybody, in a hurry, you see this? I said, how much? I said, real. He said, give me 5. Give me 10. Give me 50. I can mint 5 million rials just like that with this Christian deception. Here is a publication, Christian publication, beautiful colored picture. It says, Christian witness among Muslims, Shahada. We were supposed to be doing the job. Allah says in the Holy Quran, لِيَكُونَ الرَّسُولُ شَهِدًا عَلَيْكُمْ وَتَكُونُوا شُهَدَ عَلَى النَّاسِ. As the Rasul was a witness to you, you, watakunu, and the whole lot of you are to be the witness to mankind. We haven't done the job. We are not doing the job. So they are doing it. Christian witness among Muslims. And on the cover you see the picture of a Sudanese or a Ghanaian or a Nigerian with a subhi in his hand. You know, some of our brothers have. Subhanallah, subhanallah, they read. Subhi. And it's written here at the bottom, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُبَشِّرُكِ بِكَلِمَةٍ مِّنْهُ إِسْمُهُ الْمَسِيحُ هُ إِسَى ابْنُ مَرْيَمَا. What are you going to do now? Kiss it and put it with the Quran, a snake in the house. Here is another publication. Why I became a Christian, by Sultan Muhammad Paul. Sultan Muhammad has now become Paul, a Pakistani gentleman. He's become Paul. You open the, flip the pages, you find verses of the Quran. What do? Kiss it and put it next to the Quran. You can't tear it, you can't burn it, you can't throw it. We are trained for that. Allah's kalam, we must respect. So they catch you. Quranic verses, the only thing left for you to do now in the third world, you know, India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Africa, kiss it and put it with the Quran. Another snake in the house. Where did they get it from? Somehow, they attribute this to Hazrat Isa alayhi salam. In the Bible it says, Jesus is saying, be ye as wise as serpents, be clever like the snake. Be ye as wise as serpents and as harmless as doves. I don't know what he meant. I have been racking my brains to find out, how can you be wise like a snake? You Ashraf al-Makhlukat, the Christians say that man is created in the image of God. You are like God in what your makeup, and you be wise like a snake. How can you be wise like a snake? Poor snake. You know how wise it is? The snakes, you know how wise they are? 90% of the snakes of the world are non-poisonous. 90%. Out of every 100 you see, there's only about 10 out of 100 they can bite and kill you, harm you. 90% are absolutely harmless, and they're needed. In this ecology, they are needed. But we kill each and every snake we see. And the poor snake doesn't say, look, I'm non-poisonous, don't kill me, I'm your friend. I eat rats, I say, please, no, the poor thing, he's got no brains. You know, everyone gets killed, 100%, you see a snake, kill it. And 90% are harmless poor things. See, but I don't know, in the Bible it says that you, his followers, the Christians, must be as wise as serpents, clever like the snakes. This is really snaky business, as you can see. The way they are doing is exactly like a snake. But I don't know whether Jesus uttered those words. But it is there in their book. Pakistan, in the Bangladeshis, in America, in England, all over the place. The Arabs, all over the place. They said, you see, previously, if we wanted to preach our deen to them, we had to go to foreign land. Now we can work from a home base, sleep with the wife and children, and we can do the job. Number one.
At-tabshir.
Number two. When we went out to foreign lands, to India or Pakistan or Bangladesh, we had to learn the language of the native. You go to Indonesia, you must learn Indonesian. You go to Malaysia, you learn Malaysian. You go to Pakistan, you learn Urdu. Foreign languages they have to learn to preach to you. Now, he said, these people, they already learned our language and they come to our country. So we don't have to learn even their language. God is making things easy for us. When we went to foreign lands, we had to accept their culture, their backwardness. We had to go to their homes, sitting on the grass mat, flies buzzing, smoke from the kitchen, smarting your eyes, no more. Now these people, they live like us, culturally, sofa and chairs, you know, dining room sets, and he says now culturally also, they are prepared to receive the message. Previously, when we went to the motherlands, to their own countries, if we perverted a Muslim into Christianity, he was in a minority. He stood out like a sore thumb. Everybody knows in Qatar, in Doha, that Khabis, you know, he has turned away from Islam. Everybody will point a finger at him, that guy there, he's a murtad. That guy there is a murtad, no more. Now we can absorb him in a majority. 220 million people in America, to have another Arab there or a Bangladeshi as a Christian, he gets easily absorbed. In England, 60 million there, it's as easy to absorb these people. They are not longer any sore thumb. They are one in a majority in our country. Obviously, the governments of those countries, they were not happy at us converting them. Now mind, they were helpless. Like Pakistan is a helpless nation. She can do nothing. If she starts saying, hey, no more missionaries, maybe the Americans will turn on the screw, says no almonds for you. So the poor man, he doesn't like it, but he can't help it. He has allowed these people to come in, make inroads into the territory. They're not happy, but they're helpless. But now our governments are happy to have these people absorbed into our culture and into our religion. Advantages after advantages they have against us. Force of circumstances created the Islamic Propagation Center International in South Africa. Force of circumstances. It was not planned that we want to do such and such a job. Circumstances forcing us into situations. And as a result of that, we have reached a stage today that we are publishing books beside the munazaras and the lectures, videotapes and cassettes. We are publishing books, 100,000 at a time. This one here, so far we have done more than 300,000 for free distribution. The title is What the Bible Says About Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, proving from the Christian Bible that our Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam was foretold. Basharat was given in the previous scriptures. And we give reference from the Quran. Allah says, Qul, tell them. Ara'aytum, Qul ara'aytum in kana. Qul ara'aytum in kana in dillah wa kafartum bihi wa shahida shahidum min bani Israel ala mithrihi. Says, can't you see whether this is from God or not, this Quran? And a witness from among the children of Israel, from the Bani Israel, he bore witness of one like him. وَشَهِدَ شَاهِدٌ مِّن بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ لَا مِثْلِهِ فَآمَنَ وَاسْتَكْبَرْتُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الظَّالِمِينَ. He says, and they believe, but you are puffed up with pride, you don't want to accept. Now we say Allah promised such a prophet that one like has one from among the Bani Israel. And we find this also in the Christian Bible, in the book of Deuteronomy, that is the fifth book of Moses. Chapter 18, verse 18, it says in Arabic, our brother won't have to translate. He says, "Uqimu lahum nabiyyan min wasati ikhwatihim mithlaka, like you. Wa ajalu kalami fi famihi, fayakallamuhum bi kulli ma usihi bihi. Wa yakunu anna al-insana alladhi la yasma'u li kalami yatakallamu bihi bi ismi ana utalibuhu." In English, he says, "I will raise them up a prophet from among the brethren, like unto thee, like you, O Musa, I will raise them up a prophet from among the brethren, like unto thee, and I will put my words in his mouth, and he shall speak unto them all that I shall command him. Verse 19, and it will come to pass, it's surely going to happen, that whosoever will not hearken unto my words, which he, that prophet, shall speak in my name, I will require it of him. In the Roman Catholic version of the Bible, God says, I will take revenge upon anybody who will not listen to that prophet. Now this book is a tafsir, an interpretation of those verses. And they have been available free, but you can buy them tonight. Look, they had to be airlifted from Jeddah, and it's quite a costly business. In our own countries and around, if you write to us, we'll send you free. But don't kill us. Don't kill the goose that lays the golden egg. Let us survive. So tonight, 13 of these in English are available, and 5 in Arabic. They are in batches. Arabic, these books are also translated into Arabic. They are available in the foyer outside. Here's another publication, Christ in Islam. What is the position of the Masih in the house of Islam? We printed these, 100,000 at a time. First print, 100,000. Second print, 100,000. Third print, 50,000. So far, we have done 250,000 over a period. Now, if I told you at the beginning that this beggar here has done more than 300,000 there, has done 250,000 here, the Muslims said, no, you are lying. Is it possible Muslims doing 250,000 books? I says, my dear brothers and my sisters, one little group, 84 million copies of one book and 95 languages, and that book is 192 pages. This is only a booklet. I did 250,000. Why shouldn't you believe me? If I wanted to put, add 1,000,000 there, it's easy. Tell the printer, put 1,000,000, man, put 5,000,000 there. No, no, wallah. We did 250,000 so far for free distribution. Now we are giving permission to each and everyone, everywhere. You reproduce this for free distribution, offer sale, sell it, translate it into any language, no royalties required and no copyrights. Go and do the job. Name, the name of God Almighty. What is his name? To us, we know his name is Allah. But there are people, his name is Jehovah. Some say something else, something else, something else, something else. What is his name? So we go on to prove that in the language of Moses, Jesus and Muhammad, the name for God Almighty is Allah. And this word Allah is in the Christian Bible. In every language of the world, in the 2,000 languages, the word Allah is still there. They have not been able to change that. It's an amazing situation. The name Jehovah was not there in the original. In the New Testament, it's not there at all. But the name Allah in 2,000 different languages, it is still there. I said, you know, you, my Christian brethren, you see it, you see the word, you utter the word, you hear the sound, and yet you don't catch it. As Allah says, ثُمُّمْ بُكْمٌ أُمْيٌ فَهُمْ لَا يَرْجِعُونَ. You see it, you utter it, you hear it, and yet you still don't catch. Amazing. Now this book explains that. That how is it possible that a man sees, he reads, he hears the sound, and he still doesn't recognize that he's uttering the word Allah. Crucifixion or crucifixion. Very difficult to translate. Crucifixion or crucifixion. It sounds the same. What is this? You see, the first fiction in English is F-I-X-I-O-N, fiction, which means to fix a person on the cross and kill. The second fiction is F-I-C-T-I-O-N, fiction means a fairy tale. And Allah tells in the Quran, illatibazan. They only follow conjecture, guesswork, fiction. وَمَا قَتَلُهُ يَقِينًا, for of a surety they killed him not. بَلْ رَفَعُ اللَّهُ إِلَيْهِ, but Allah took him up to himself. This book deals with that subject. God's word. Is the Bible God's word? This Bible, is it Allah's kalam? This book deals with that. Now you master these little booklets. And wallah, I can assure you, there isn't a Christian born who can stand before you. These are the little pebbles that Hazrat Dawud alayhi salam picked up. You remember? The battle between the Bani Israel and the Palestinian has been going on for 3,000 years. It's nothing new. 3,000 years, you know, the battle is going on. And you read in the Bible that these Jews, when they went into Palestine, they destroyed them utterly. They killed men, women and children, even sucklings, little babies were not spared, and not even donkeys. The Bible tells you again and again, they destroyed them utterly. The Goshenites that destroyed them utterly, finished them up all for good, wiped them out. At one stage in the history of this conflict, the Palestinians, they have in their midst a giant called Jalut, Goliath, an 8-foot giant. So they are on a hilltop, and on the opposite hill are the Bani Israel. And
Jalut. Because of his size, he's shouting, "Say, you Jews, is there anybody there who can take me on? I'll chew you alive. Come, come." And the Jews were shivering in their pants. I don't know whether they were wearing pants those days, but figuratively, they shiver in their pants. Nobody is prepared to take him on. Because if he just catches one of them, they'll crush him, crush him. But little Dawood is somewhere around. What is he doing? He's looking after his father's sheep. He's a shepherd boy. He was no Rasul then, no Nabi then. He was a shepherd boy looking after his father's sheep. And he sees this Jalut and it makes his mouth water. Very tempting. I say, this guy here is a sitting duck. He's a sitting target for me. So he comes to Talut, Saul, and offers his services. Look, I can take him on. So what? You go look after your father's sheep, man. The young man is so enthusiastic. He says, "No, man, you don't know. This fellow here, I can knock him out." That enthusiasm. So Talut, Saul, he offers his sword and his shield. So look, take this. So little Dawood says, "Look, I haven't handled this in my life before. But I have my sling." Sling. A toy? A toy? You want to kill a giant with a toy? A bigger joke. It is a joke, you, when we veterans of so many wars, we are terrified to face this Jalut, and you, and now with a toy. He said, "Look, you just wait and watch. Give me permission." So Talut says, "All right, go." So he walks down the hill at the stream. He picks up a few pebbles, stones. He puts one in the pouch. This sling with the rubber was not invented then. There was no rubber then. So he takes his pouch with two strings, he puts a stone and he swings. Wing, 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 wing. And at the right moment, he lets it go. He is a good marksman. He has been killing birds with it. He has been killing rabbits with it. He is a good marksman. That's his practice, pastime. And he swings and he lets go at the right moment. And the little stone strikes Jalut on the forehead, cracks his skull, and the giant falls. Little Dawood rushes up, takes his own sword and chops off his head. So Allah says, وَقَتَلَ دَاوُدُ جَالُوتَ And Dawood killed Jalut, وَآتَاهُ اللَّهُ الْمُلْكَ And Allah gave him dominion, وَالْحِكْمَةَ And wisdom, وَعَلَّمُهُ مِمَّا يَشَاءَ And whatever else he willed. Now, these little booklets are those stones. To knock the Jalut's head, whether American Christian or British Christian or German Christians or whatever Christian, to crack his skull, بَلْ نَقْزِفُ بِالْحَقِّ عَلَى الْبَاطِلِ فَيَدْمَغُهُ فَازَهُ وَزَاهِكُمْ وَلَكُمُ الْوَيْلُ مِمَّا تَصِفُونَ These are those little stones. I want you to pick them up. You'll have to pay something. I don't know what. You'll have to pay the man there. He's outside. You pick up these stones and take them and master them. And I tell you, there isn't a Christian born who will be able to stand before you. وَآخِرُ الدَّعْوَانَ أَنِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ
وبعد فباسمكم أيها الإخوة جميعا نتوجه بالشكر الجزيل إلى حضرة الأستاذ الداعية الإسلامي الكبير أحمد ديدات على محاضرته القيمة هذه ونفتح باب المناقشة تفضل
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته
عليكم السلام
نشكر الداعية الإسلامي الكبير الشيخ أحمد ديدات ونطلب منه إن كانت لديه أفكار كيفية تطوير الدعوة كيف نقود العالم كله إلى اتباع الإسلام ومنهج الإسلام وهل لديه أساليب حديثة أو طرق حديثة لدعوة الإسلام وشكرا
Repeat it in the mic so people can hear in English then I'll answer
الأخ يشكر السيد أحمد
No, no, no In English, you repeat that in English so okay. I'll know
اعتقدت أنهم لم يسمعوا.
I can ask in English, please.
Oh, then better still, please.
Mr. Ahmad Didat, what do you think about the ideal plan to lead the world to our way to Islam, of Islam, in this time? Have you some modern means for this? How are you? How you represent? To the Islamic invocation in the future.
First he thanks you, then he says, do you have any method how we can extend this da'wah to the world and take our position?
Yes. You see, each and every group that you come across, you will have to develop systems of bringing them towards Islam. Allah gives us the secret of this in the ayah I read to you, قُلْ يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ, say, O people of the book, تَعَالَ, come, إِلَىٰ كَلِمَةٍ سَوَائِن بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَكُمْ, that we come to common terms as between us and you. Let us get onto a common platform. Let us find some common denominator between ourselves and the other side. And there is no better way. And Allah is showing us in the Quran, like He's speaking, when He's speaking to the people, the Jews and the Christians. You see, the Jews and the Christians were boasting that we are the people of the book. We are a people with the scripture. You Arabs, you barbarians, you haven't got a book to your credit before Islam. You haven't got a prophet to your credit. You know, backward people, illiterate people. We are a learned people. We have a book, books, scriptures. So Allah Bari Ta'ala addresses them. Ya Ahl al-Kitab, with such respect, O people of the book, La taghlu fi dinikum, say, do not go to extremes in your religion. Wa la taqulu ala Allah illa al-haq, but, and do not say anything about Allah except the truth. This is reasoning with them. They love to hear that we are a learned people, people with the scripture, so Allah addresses them. The Jews were boasting that we are the chosen people. Allah drowned Fir'aun and his soldiers in his army in our very sight. Allah gave us clouds, shelter of clouds for 40 years. He gave us manna and salwa in the desert. So Allah Bari Ta'ala reminds them, Ya Bani Israel, askuru ni'mati allati an'amtu alaykum. Says, O Bani Israel, O children of Israel, remember the special favors which I did unto you. Wa anni faddaltukum alal alameen, that I preferred you above all the peoples of the earth for my special favors. So Allah Bari Ta'ala is showing us, you speak to a people according to their own background and their own experience. There is no better way. And if we master a little of their background, you got to. Because otherwise you can't correlate. The man tells you that Christ died for your sins. He says, no, my Quran says, wama kataluhu wama salabuhu. He said Christ died. You say he didn't die. So he's asking you, where did you get it? He says, from the Quran. He said, where did the Quran come from? So we said, look, Allah Bari Ta'ala, he revealed it to his Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So he laughs. He says, what? That man, how many wives did he have? You know, he copied this book from the Jews and the Christians. You know, he spread his religion at the point of the sword. Now there is a war. But if you can correlate, he said, now let's have a look. Allah is telling you, he says, tell them, قُلْ هَاتُوا بُرْحَانَكُمْ. Anything the man claims, anybody, whether Jew or Christian or Hindu, anybody makes any claim, Allah says, Kul hatu burhanakum. Tell them, where is your burhan, your proof, your certificate that entitles you to Jannah and destines us to Jahannam, hell. Let us have a look at your proof. Now this is the secret, which open secret, which you have not learned yet. You have to learn this. Hatu burhanakum. So the man says, here, it is in my book. So you deal with it. Wallah, it is so easy. These little booklets are teaching you. It's so easy once you handle his burhan. His proof, let's have a look what it says. And wallah is not saying what he's telling you. He says Jesus is God. He says Jesus is God. He said, look, did he claim to be God? If there is any way in your book, I'm telling the Christians in mass meetings, any way in your book, in any version of the Bible, you have a dozen different versions, any version of the Bible where Jesus says, I'm God, I said, I'm prepared to accept him as God. Where Jesus says, worship me, I'm prepared to worship him. Show me in your book, your burhan. So he's asking me, you mean to say it's not there? I said, you show me. Because Allah shows in the Quran that he never made any such claims. So it's such a fantastic way. Wallah, it is so easy and so pleasant. It's like a game of chess, intellectual chess you are playing with him, and you are always on top.
ما بدك نترجم؟
ترجم؟ طيب بعد شوي.
طبعا هذا السؤال عن الدعوة وعن تطوير الدعوة، طبعا يعني هناك أشياء كثيرة جدا، لكن أفضل شيء هو أن نأخذ من القرآن، لما ربنا سبحانه وتعالى يقول كن يا أهل الكتاب تعالوا إلى كلمة سواء بيننا وبينكم، فهذه الخطوة الأولى. ولا بد أن تعرف الخلفية والنفسية والتفكير لهؤلاء الناس الذين تتعامل معهم. مثلا على سبيل المثال بنقول اليهود يعتبروا نفسهم بأنهم الأمة المختارة، ويقولوا بأن الله سبحانه وتعالى أعطاهم الغيوم لتحميهم لمدة 40 سنة وأعطاهم المن والسلوى، لكن ربنا سبحانه وتعالى بيقول اذكروا نعمتي التي أنعمت عليكم وأني فضلتكم على العالمين. لما بدك تيجي تناقش مع واحد مسيحي، تعال ما هو برهانك؟ طبعا هم يعتدوا بأنهم جماعة مثقفين، بأنهم عندهم أنبياء، عندهم كتب مقدسة. العرب ما كان عندهم كتب مقدسة، ما كان عندهم أنبياء، فهو لما بده يجي يحكي شيء، طيب النبي سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم من أين له بالقرآن؟ من الله، من الوحي. ما هو برهانك؟ الله سبحانه وتعالى بيقول هاتوا برهانكم. فالعملية لابد أن تطلب منه البراهين. إذا بقول لك أن الإنجيل مثلا عيسى هو الله، طيب هل عيسى عليه السلام ذكر في أي مكان مثبت بأنه هو الله أو قال اعبدوني؟ طبعا هو بيقول يعني مش موجودة، بدك تأكد له أنها مش موجودة. وهذه الكتب الصغيرة تثبت بعد الاطلاع على يعني على أشياء كثيرة جدا بأنه ما يدعوه هو غير مكتوب، هو غير مكتوب في الكتاب المقدس تبعهم حتى الموجود الآن. فالعملية عملية يعني كبيرة جدا، لكن الإنسان يستعين بالقرآن وبهدي القرآن، يعرف الإنسان الذي يتعامل معه وما لازم يوصلها لدرجة حرب ونخره. لا، يعني لابد أن نمارس الدعوة بالبرهان، بالكلمة الطيبة، بالموعظة، بالحكمة.
Well, I'm a Christian. I'm a Ghanaian. I have been actually looking or fighting to know the truth, because I believe that we've all been destined to a life, and after that we have to pay for whatever we do on this earth. And when I came here about a year now, I have been actually struggling, and incidentally I had an address and I wrote to Saudi, and incidentally all the pamphlets he mentioned, I've got all and I read them all. But I got one or two questions to ask, and that is first, it's on who moved the stone. And in fact, I really enjoyed everything there, but the only thing which baffles me is, was it really that Christ died and his body was being removed from where he was placed? Because I couldn't just get that portion properly. So I'm very glad that the man who wrote it is he himself is here. He will enlighten me about that. And the second question to is...
No, one at a time.
Thank you.
You like to explain the question is?
Yes. الأخ مسيحي من غانا، وهو يبحث عن الحقيقة ويؤمن بالآخرة، وقبل سنة تقريبا حصل على بعض النشرات ولديه سؤال، وسؤاله عن سيدنا عيسى، هل هو صلب؟ هل مات؟ كيف نقر؟ من نقره؟
The brother from Ghana is referring to this little stone. This one here. It says here, who moved the stone? You see, the Christian world is intrigued. For 2,000 years, they are worried. Who moved the stone? It's not the Kaaba stone. They say that Jesus Christ, after his alleged crucifixion, what they say that he was killed, and that he was given a burial bath, and he was put a shroud around him, and they put him into a sepulchre. A sepulchre is a cave-like thing, big roomy chamber, which according to a Christian authority, Jim Bishop, he said it was 5 feet wide by 7 feet high by 15 feet deep with a ledge of ledges inside. And after the body was put inside, a big stone was put into place. Now, Sunday morning, first day of the week, according to the Christian scriptures, Mary Magdalene goes to the tomb. For what? She goes to anoint him, says the Bible. What is anoint? Anoint comes from the Hebrew word masaha, Arabic masaha, which means to rub, to massage, to anoint. That's what she went to do. So we are asking our Christian friends, do Jews massage dead bodies after 3 days? Do they? They said no. Do Christians massage dead bodies after 3 days? They said no. We Muslims, we are the closest to the Jew.
رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من قال حين يسمع النداء اللهم رب هذه الدعوة التامة والصلاة القائمة آت محمدا الوسيلة والفضيلة وابعثه مقاما محمودا الذي وعدته حلت له شفاعتي يوم القيامة رواه البخاري.
ونتابع معكم الآن أيها الأخوة والأخوات ما تبقى من الندوة الدينية للداعية أحمد ديدات.
نضع خطة ونريد من السيد أحمد ديدات أن يضع الخطة وأن يكون العمل جماعي. فكان رد السيد أحمد ديدات بأن هذا الشاب الذي تحدث يبدو أن لديه أفكار طيبة، يبدو أنه واعي، يبدو أنه قوي الشخصية، فلماذا لا يقوم بهذه المهمة؟ لماذا أي واحد فينا يتوقع من الآخرين؟ ليش حتى يكون عندنا الجبن ونتوقع من الآخرين؟ أنت أعمل، لو تعمل، لو تساوي، لو إلى آخره. بكون إحنا بجهودنا البسيطة وإمكانياتنا، مثلا أخذ صورة لطفل فلسطيني، اليهود بحاولوا يأخذوا والأم بدها تأخذوا من اليهود، شاف صورة تانية فصورة من الصور خرجته يبكي، صورة أخرى أثارت غضبه، فهو يحاور في جميع المناطق في بلده وفي أمريكا وفي بريطانيا كيف يوصل هذه الحقائق ويحصل على المشاعر الحقيقية حتى يحرك مشاعرهم. بيكون إذا يكتب خبر في جريدة بمر عليها شيء بسيط، يعني يتعاطف معها شيء بسيط، وبعدين بمشي بده يشوف شو سعر العملة، بده يشوف شو أخبار الرياضة، بده يشوف كذا وكذا، تفقد قيمتها. لكن هو بيجي بيركز وبيحاول من ناحية نفسية من ناحية علمية كيف يؤثر على هؤلاء الناس بما في اليهود وبما فيه النصارى. فلا بد، يعني جوهر الموضوع، لابد انه كل واحد فينا يفكر ويعمل ويحاور. وذكر بانه هو يعني مقدم جوائز، الجائزة الاولى 1000 دينار كويتي، الجائزة الثانية 500، في جوائز اخرى 50 لمن يستطيع ان يحصل على صورة زي اللي فرجانا اياها، ويكتب تعليق من 400 كلمة. فالهدف من هذا، الهدف انه الناس يتحركوا، الناس يفكروا، انه يصبح هذا الشيء يعني شيء من الهم بالنسبة لهم، يعطوه شيء من الفكر الجاد.
ونشكر باسمكم جميعا الأستاذ أحمد ديدات على محاضرته وعلى إجاباته على الاستفسارات والأسئلة، ونشكر كذلك المهندس جميل يونس على ترجمته للمحاضرة.